Hey everyone, Mo here, and before the video begins, I just want to let you guys know that my schedule has opened up for me to do coaching again. So if you're interested in private one-on-one coaching for me to help you, whether you're a newer player and you want to excel at the game very quickly and learn the fundamentals without developing any bad habits early, or if you're an experienced player who's already maybe platinum or diamond in your top 1%, but you need some help filling in the gap to get you to that 0.01%, to make you just some of the best, then hit me up on Discord and I can get you in some private one-on-one coaching lessons to help you polish up any skills you want to refine and help you learn all of the secrets to becoming a top player. That's it. I hope you enjoy the video.
All right, the Ash Sejuani deck. This is, in my opinion, like the best deck in the game. Let me get rid of these. We need Warmothers. She wonders if this isn't going to be too crazy here. I guess most of their units are really big. That's why I think this is only a 2-of in my deck. That's a 1-of. Okay, good. Yeah, I say it's only a 1 or 2 of because the deck I'm most concerned about, I think this is the best deck in the meta. So there's no reason to have a 3 of in your deck that's bad against what you think is the best deck in the meta, you know? That just doesn't make sense. That just don't make no sense. I can watch a video anytime. I can't be live anytime. More like, I can't be live anytime. More like, I only stream an hour a day because I'm... irresponsible. So you have to catch me while I'm here. I understand what you're saying, DPC. Alright, one calling strike down. Wow, we drew into triple warding stone. That would have been nutty. Sure. We can hopefully grasp this. I mean, obviously, you could have a Elixir of Iron. We just kind of hope he doesn't. Usually people only play like two. Oh, or he's playing Fury of the North. Okay. That's cool too, I guess. No, we got big money. I mean, big mana. We've got big mana, chat. I guess let's just pass and see what he does. Reckoning? Ooh. Ayaya! Not today, baby. Not today, baby. We ain't about it. Is it better to just Warmothers here? I think it is. I think it's better to just Warmothers here, because I think I'm going to lose my mana ramps when I play. If I play this She Who Wanders, I lose my mana ramps. I want to play this soon, so. Sure. We're probably taking 5 here. Oh god. Taking a lot. Okay, so the best move here would have just been Soul Gorger into Avalanche. I'm just gonna pull my Trindy Mirror. Probably not, right? Yeah. Okay. Please do this. Keep as many Manny Rampers as possible. This should be okay, though. Ooh, what a big draw. What a big draw. Might as well attack before he plays his Sejuani. Marsh one, that's fine. Okay, I think we're just gonna Withering Wheel here then, when he goes block. Not take just free damage. Cool. Assessor, sure. We're chilling. Oh yeah, chat. Oh yeah, chat. 3-0. 3-0, baby. What are we playing against here? Deep? Deep's weak to Ruination because they have to overextend. They're weak to Ruination and Vengeance. We'll keep this in case he tries to get aggro on us, but we really don't need something like an Avalanche because he's not going to get that aggro on us, or at least he shouldn't. So we really just needed to look for Ruination, and we really need to look for a Vengeance to kill Nautilus. Because if you can just kill Nautilus, then we're fine, right? And really, the biggest threat here is actually just the Maokai. We want to be sure we can kill Maokai. We need a mana ramp and try and get super explosive. Sure. We can take three. We'll save this for a turn where he plays Maokai. Or multiple units. That's not a Maokai. But we'll go and do this. And then worst case scenario, he plays another 3-2. Jaw Hunters? Oh, that's not that bad. We have a Vial Feast. Okay. We can kill that. This card's kind of threatening because it helps him get deep. Okay, we'll go and kill that. We haven't gotten any mana ramp, which kind of sucks. Ideally, we could have ramped a little bit faster, get into this Warmothers. Soul Gorger, we're gonna put some pressure on him. Now that I think about it, I feel like this matchup's either gonna be really, really easy. Because it's like, oh, like none of your units matter because I have stuff like, you can't get really big because of Ruination and Atrocity. I mean, not Ruination and Vengeance. But also part of me is like, I actually don't have a good way to stop like a Maokai, right? So if you like Maokai ults me, I actually don't have an answer to that. Unless I draw two trendy mirrors. Ooh, buddy. Did I grasp that? Okay. Well, let's play another one. How far is he from deep? I'm assuming he doesn't have any more toss cards or he would have been using them. So we can just go like really big here with some Trindamirs and stuff. He's like 8 away? 7 away. 7 away from deep. Oh, there's a Maokai. So, it might be in some trouble here. He's only 11 out of 25, so he's not even halfway there. But not even halfway there. Is it a Survival Feast? Okay. So we can get one Maokai down with these, like, Ruinations and Grasps and stuff. If he would have blocked the one, that would have been really nice. Oh, no, he did have... He has Jettison. I might be scared, chat. If he doesn't have a second Maokai in his hand, we could be okay. If he does have second Maokai, we could be in trouble. Okay, we're just gonna go for a Ruination here to kind of clear up the board. So we're gonna go for a little board wipe. So his Maokai is now going to be, is it 19 out of 25 now? Before or after the board wipe? Now it's 24 out of 25. So basically if he just plays Maokai, I'm kind of in trouble. So ideally I could just kill him. Yeah, so it's leveled now. So hopefully I can just kill him before he Maokai ults me. Which should be this turn. As long as he doesn't have a Vengeance. That's fine. Alright, I'm gonna go for it, chat. The only card you could have here is Vengeance. Cool. 5-0. Hecarim Elise. Interesting. I have no idea what this is, guys. I'll keep this in case it's spiders. I'll keep this in case it's early game aggro. He used aggro, but they suck egg. Yeah, he used sucks egg. What you got for me, big papa? Yeah, I don't know what this guy's playing, so I kept this for the spider rush, and then I kept this for just general aggro rush. When you get to Masters on EU, but I want to wait until I'm like top 50 at least, like top 50 minimum NA before I start focusing on EU. Pass. We don't have to do anything here with all of these different last breaths. We'll go ahead and kill this just because I don't want to take double damage from shit. This card's kind of scary. Yeah, it almost looks like a Snapvine style deck. If I could have one more mana ramp, I'd be chilling. Okay, that's not bad. I mean, he's not playing They Who Endure because he's not in Freljord, so we don't have to worry about that card. Boo! No Vile Feast. Vile Feast would have been sick. Alright, we have these avalanches. Oh, we also have a mana ramper. We'll pass. We'll see what he does. He just drops like a Hecarim and we could be in trouble. But maybe he's afraid to drop Hecarim? Okay. That's nice. We'll play Life Gorger. Best case scenario is we top deck Ruination, and then he plays a Hecarim. I'll hit him with that. The goal here is to keep at least 3 spell mana, so that way I can Warmother's next turn. So like, I'll do another avalanche here if I have to. Like if he plays something else here and gives me Pryo, yeah. Here we go. That's really big. That kills everything and I don't take triggers from this collector. And then next turn I can still Warmother's. Sure, I'll take 3 damage. Fine by me, man. And then there's no way he attacks me because I'll just gain the 3 back that he just did. So he literally just wasted a Mark of the Isle. Cool. We'll take that. And then Warmother value is nutty. Sure, get 5 damage in. GG, baby! 2 clean, 7-0. Oh my god, this deck is so good. We're only 7 games in. I'm hoping to get to 10. I'll put right here, or somewhere on the screen, how many games we ended up getting to before we lost a game with it. This deck looks very, very promising. It's very, very good so far. It's beaten all types of deck. It's beaten aggro. It's beaten control. It's beaten deep. It's beaten midrange. It's all around really good, so I'll post the finalized deck list in the comments below or in the description below. Make sure you check that out. Go ahead and follow me on Twitch, where I stream every single day at 12 noon Central Time. Subscribe here on YouTube, because I post at least 3 videos a week. and join the Discord so you don't miss any notifications. Let me know in the comments what video you want to see next, and make sure to like, because that really helps with the YouTube algorithm. If you like the video, so like the video. And that's it. Now, see you in the next one.